It's really cold out today. It's like 20 degrees. Isn't this incredible? Look at these beautiful women. Feel that stone. It's just so tactile. And here you can see there's Leo, Cancer. There's Gemini, Taurus, Aries.
The sundial has been there in Fairmont Park interacting with the elements for over 100 years. Like many artists, Sterling Calder felt both his own mortality and the desire, the hope for the immortality of art. For people who walk up to this sundial, I think there is that double sense of time passing and the sense that certain things also remain. My name is Jed Pearl, and I'm working on the first full-length biography of Alexander Calder, the father of Sterling Calder, who created the sundial we're talking about today.
I'm Susan Weiler, and I'm a landscape architect. And I'm very interested in the integration of art and landscape, particularly in public art.
You might say that the sundial is an extraordinarily elaborate outdoor table. There are four female figures which symbolize the four seasons.
Each of them hold a plant that is representative of that season.
Spring with a rose.
Summer is poppy, where you start getting those vibrant colors of summer.
Autumn wears grapes in her hair. Winter has a branch of pine.
They're hauntingly beautiful.
It's interesting. Sterling Calder in the 1910s and 20s was one of the most famous sculptors in America and was known for the sexiness, actually, of his female figures. We sometimes forget that in the 1880s and 90s, Philadelphia, rather than New York, was the hotbed of new art in America. Sterling Calder was very much a part of all that excitement. He's the middle generation in three generations of sculptors. His father, Alexander Milne Calder, was born in Scotland. As a young man, came to Philadelphia and became the sculptor in residence for the Philadelphia City Hall, working for decades on an enormous number of sculpture that covers that huge kind of wedding cake of a building. Sterling, to his son, looked like a bit of an old-fashioned guy. So Sandy Calder, the inventor of the mobile, he used to sometimes mockingly refer to his father, who had a kind of English elegance about him, as Sir Sterling.
And so that pretty much puts Sterling right smack in the middle of them in artistic tradition.
And Sterling Calder has, I think, not gotten as much credit as he deserves as a modern man, a man who wanted to reinvent sculpture and reimagine sculpture.
Every step you come closer to this sculpture, the more you come to understand why the piece is there. And you see the sundial, and then you start reading the inscriptions upon it.
Calder inscribed on the base the words, "Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your hour doth come."
You have to walk your way around the whole sculpture, feeling your way around it to understand what those words are, just to make out what they are, not even to think about what they mean. And if it's rained, the water catches in each of the little crevices of each little letter, and it's even more astounding. "Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your hour doth come."